Taiwan's National Day, and the government is showing off its military might. China has 1,000 missiles pointed at Taiwan, but today the president's showing he's got a long-range missile too. Chen Shui-bian is trying to look tough in his final months in power. Since 2000, he's taken a muscular stance against China's threats, asserting Taiwan's independence from mainland rule.
那事实上对台湾政府跟2300万人民来讲，我们绝对无意跟中国来进行所谓的军备竞赛，我们只希望能够做好自我国防的强化，以及自我防卫能力的提升。
6,500 kilometres away, on Australia's Gold Coast, is a far more troublesome opponent. Ligi Li is a Taiwanese-Australian fashion designer based at Sanctuary Cove. She's frail from a recent accident and nervous about travelling, never leaving home without her two female bodyguards. Yet she's done more damage to Chen Shui-bian than China's entire military arsenal.
I feel very proud of myself. I am strong enough, brave enough to say, go down the president, Chen Shui-bian. He is a liar.
Inside her living room is the smoking gun of Taiwan's corruption scandal. A pile of receipts from the mother of all shopping sprees.
We gave all the receipts to Chen Shui-bian's wife through my cousin, and they use it for, you know, like exchange for money, for cash.
The receipts have already led to the president's wife being charged with fraud. And they could even see Chen Shui-bian in the dock when he steps down in May.
He promised to take us to a bright future, a better future. And he himself is so corrupted. I cannot tolerate that.
Chen Shui-bian's election sent shockwaves through Taiwan and the region. For half a century, these islands had been ruled by the KMT, a party of Chinese nationalists who fled the mainland after the Communist Revolution. Chen was the first opposition politician to come to power and the first committed to full independence from China. It's been a turbulent reign with a faltering economy and increasing tensions with the mainland. Chen was only narrowly re-elected in 2004 after an assassination attempt his opponents claimed he staged for sympathy. But his troubles really began when Ligi Li went shopping. During frequent business trips staying in the Hyatt Hotel, she spent $250,000 on items ranging from accommodation to wedding banquets to diamond rings.
White diamond, white sapphire.
White diamond.
And there were smaller items like iPods, underwear, even mosquito zappers for her Gold Coast villa. One day her cousin asked if she could have all the receipts to give to the First Lady.
Exquisite. Originally, my cousin, Li Bijun, told me the president's wife is collecting all the unwanted invoices for charity.
Anywhere else that would seem a strange request, but not in Taiwan. You see, people here are passionate about keeping receipts. The reason is the government holds regular receipts lotteries to discourage the black economy. Now, if your receipt numbers come up in newspaper advertisements, you can win tens of thousands of dollars. So people not only collect receipts, many give them to charities, so they'll have a chance of cashing in big time. But it turned out the president's wife wasn't collecting for charity. Wushu Chen, who is wheelchair bound from an accident, was collecting receipts for herself. What's more, she was claiming reimbursement for them, saying they were items she had bought as gifts for diplomats. So you found out the president's wife was actually claiming money from your receipts?
Right. They love Hyatt Hotels invoices. It's exactly president's specification. You know, meet their dining, wining, dignitary standard. I started doubt about something is fishy, so I questioned my cousin.
Her cousin told her not to worry.
She told me, she said, the president, he has absolutely power, and we have government machine. Why you have to worry about?
But Ligi Li did worry. She asked the hotel to reprint all the receipts and, amid a blaze of publicity, took them to the prosecutor's office by the suitcase load. Sure enough, she matched the receipts the first lady had lodged as her own, right down to the mosquito zappers. The news electrified Taiwanese politics.
Ligi inadvertently triggered the whole chain of event. If there is a tip of an iceberg, her receipts were the tip of the iceberg.
Joanna Lai is a veteran of the rough and tumble of Parliament, such as this recent stoush in which she was attacked by government MPs.
I had been pushed on the floor, dragged down. People dragged my hair, I had my finger broken.
But it wasn't just the KMT-led opposition that took up the fight. Many of the president's own supporters turned on him too. Shin Ming Te was a close friend and comrade of Chen's in their struggle to bring democracy to Taiwan. Known as Taiwan's Nelson Mandela, he spent 25 years in prison for opposing the KMT's martial law. Now he accuses Chen of being as bad as the dictators he replaced. Has led massive protests against the president, the demonstrators wearing red shirts to express their anger. But inside the presidential palace, Chen Shui-bian told me his old comrades had lost their way. How do you respond to these very strong attacks? Are you a corrupt president? Did your family steal from the state?
没有的事情就是没有的事情，基于政治的原因，要扭曲，要抹黑，要误导。
The prosecutor disagreed, laying charges against the First Lady and two senior presidential aides. He also warned that Chen could be charged when he loses presidential immunity.
Chen's legacy at this point is he is truly not democratic, totally corrupt in the eyes and minds of at least a million people who have elected to walk the streets or even sleep on the street.
So why were such leading figures using other people's receipts? According to President Chen, it's top secret. To understand what that means, you need to look at some of Taiwan's diplomatic work. 3 years ago, we followed Chen as he toured the South Pacific, showering small nations with money. It's a way of buying diplomatic recognition for Taiwan, which China insists is just a breakaway province. While most aid is above board, the president also has a slush fund, called the State Affairs Fund, to give money in secret. He just has to provide receipts to claim the money back. But Chen insists that's not possible when the missions are hush-hush. He has a lot of funds available to him should it be deemed as truly involving state secrets.
So you see no other explanation other than fraud?
No other explanation.
Nor did many other Taiwanese. Shin Ming Te's red shirts not only mobilized mass rallies, but turned them into propaganda videos to spread the rage. Chen is now facing criminal charges and a possible return to jail for staging unauthorized protests. The irony is that in the old days, Chen Shui-bian was his lawyer trying to get him out of jail. Are you surprised that you've now been charged with protesting in what is now a democracy? For now, he's enjoying the comforts of freedom.
It tastes like an artichoke flower.
He invited us to one of Taipei's oldest restaurants to dine with his new partner in struggle, Ligi Li.
We are the, how do you call it, the public enemy number one, enemy number two, to Sun Ruiyuan's eyes.
Shin Ming Te admits it was Ligi Li's revelations that made him decide to act. When Chen was elected in 2000, Shi was happy to become chairman of his party. Sher enjoys legendary status in Taiwan, both as the moral conscience of the nation and the embodiment of dissident chic.
I heard everything about him through my father and my brothers, that he is their hero. And when I finally met him last year, I like him because he is a person who is true to himself.
But I must say, you look great for someone who's spent 25 years in jail.
Yes. Well, he was beaten. His teeth were beaten. All fall out. Knock off.
Cheers.
Chen Shui-bian once enjoyed similar moral authority to Sherming De. As young men, they both worked on a magazine demanding democracy and independence for Taiwan. Chen spent 8 months in prison for his writings. He bristles at his old comrade stepping back into the martyr's limelight. Chen is determined his last months will be remembered for more than the corruption scandal. He's announced he'll consult the people on whether Taiwan should apply to join the UN. China has warned of serious consequences if the March referendum goes ahead.
We believe Taiwan is a
Shin Ming Te dismisses the UN bid as a ploy to distract attention from the corruption scandal.
So, this is a political scandal. 不是我们台湾人自己要怎么说就能做到什么的。Even
so, Chen still enjoys strong support from much of the community, particularly native Taiwanese. Ligi Li took us to Snake Alley, a centuries-old market where Chen remains a hero for standing up to the mainland. And where whistleblowers like her can be treated with contempt.
If I come here by myself, people spit on me because they are Chen Shui-bian's supporter.
This is the real Chen heartland, is it?
Yes, yes. One of the guys even tell me to go home. I said, where to? Where to? They go back to Australia.
Some of her own family have shunned her for damaging Chen.
They think no matter what he did, no matter he is a liar, we support leading Taiwanese. We don't support people from China.
So it's caused a lot of resentment within your family for going public with the allegations?
Yes, yes. Yeah. Even now, my brothers, They still think I shouldn't stand up and tell the truth.
Shin Ming Te sees it in more epic terms. Like the typhoons that lash Taiwan each summer, he believes the crisis is essential to renew democracy.
Taiwan is a very beautiful place. It's very beautiful because it every year will be more rain. 被飓风所摧残，看到那个摧残的过程，也看到了它摧残过后的生命力，而灾难带来的是更美好的未来，就像我们的政治一样。
So it was that Chen Shui-bian braced for a political storm at this year's national celebrations. The public was locked out behind barbed wire and riot police. Even with such tight security, Chen cancelled his public address for fear red shirts would storm the stage. In the end, the only heckling came from the pro-China fringe. Shin Ming Te walked alone through the closed-off square in silent protest against his one-time friend. These old war horses remain locked in conflict to the bitter end. And the opposition hopes it can use the scandal to retake power in the March election. No doubt China will be watching as closely as Taiwan for the final chapter of the President versus Ligi Li.